Once, there was a man. A desert man. And one night, while he was looking at the stars, he had a revelation. He had to leave his home. He gathered the people of his tribe and told them he was leaving. Some of them wanted to come with him.
The journey is going to be long and hard, he said.
Some of them wanted to come with him anyway. And the journey was hard and long indeed. They walked days, nights. One day he stopped.
This is where I'm staying, he said.
Some of them stayed with him, although there was nothing around. He took one of the women to be his wife, but they realized she could not have kids.
Take one of my maids, she offered.
Sadly, he did. 9 months after, a baby was born. They called him Lissa, and the baby became a beautiful boy. Everybody loved him, even the wife. Years went by. One evening, the man had a feeling someone was standing on the other side of the door. He opened the door, but there was no one. Just the feeling he could have a kid with his wife. She laughed about it because she was too old. 9 months after, a baby was born. They called him Love. And the two brothers loved each other. The older brother taught everything he knew to the younger brother. And when the younger brother was 7 years old, the father took him to a trip.
Just you and I, he said.
They walked 3 days. On the third day, they put their things and went up a hill. The father made a fire camp.
We have nothing to cook,
the boy said. The father did not answer. When the fire was ready, he put his own son in the flames. In the last minute, he caught himself, put him out, hugging and crying. The boy forgave him, then went back home. The mother had a feeling something went wrong. She asked the boy, but he said nothing. She asked the father, but he said nothing. And so she demanded to kick out the maid and the boy, alone in the desert, the mother and her son. Years after, these two brothers are going to meet. Years after, these two brothers are going to love with each other. Years after, these two brothers are going to love. Years after, these two brothers are going to get jealous at each other. Years after, these two brothers are going to grieve. Years after, these two brothers are going to lie to each other. Years after, these two brothers are going to bleed. Years after, these two brothers are going to fight. Years after, these two brothers are going to hurt one another. Years after, these two brothers are going to cry. Years after, these two brothers are going to kill. Years after, these two brothers are going to die.
And like a day, the ghost can die.
We are calling you, the voice
thunder. And she cried, feeling sorry she forgot her firstborn. And he stayed with them. Every morning, the younger brother would go to the fields with a heavy heart, and the older brother would stay with his mother, like in the older days. And he would mock his younger brother for being so simple, for not knowing anything about literature, art, history, mathematics. And he would mock him, and the younger brother would say nothing, until he couldn't take it anymore, and he would start to fight back, and they would fight each other. This one with his intelligence and technology, and this one with his anger. And they would fight each other more and more, without even noticing the fields were getting drier, without even noticing the mother was getting sicker and sicker, without even noticing. It was too late.
Thank you.
In Cavern, Borodonin. Dachachmein, the Indigo. At Midatefet, Balfe Kochavim. רק ככה את יכולה להיזכר איך הכל עבר בינינו תה בשעה המתאימה וגינה פסנתר חרשית למול הצרצרים בלילה קרים לבושם בשמלות המלמלה והאדימות שלך את מתהלכת על להיות נער שמלטף ביבשתה נמציאות ולרמים בסערת כך מילים זובבים את רגליים ואם תבוא עלייך צרה את רגע מכך הערבים כבר יזהירו אותך, את רק צריכה להסתכל. השמיים לא יפלו לך לראש, רק תסתכל. נראה כתום לאור הבוקר שמפציע נראה כתום נראה וגדום Thank you.
אני מחכה למגע שלך לה.
יער, מלט.
יער מרחם. חיים
של איש
מהרב.
אבל ביני לבין זה יש תהום של פח.
אתה גם מחכה.
ציפייה וחיליון למשך רוח עדינה שמלטפת בפנים, מדגדגת בירכיים בין האצבעות של הרגליים. אבל השרב כבד והאוויר עומד, ואין הרבה חמלה, הם כולם מחכים בלב כבד שמרפה
ומתו. בתוכי אני שומעת משהו נשמע, זו רק ההתחלה.
רוח רעה סותרת את צערותיי, מקפיאה את כעסיי, משתקת את שרירי הידיים.
Between the setting of the sun and the river, I'm waiting for a touch of compassion.
A loving smile, but I'm afraid.
Are you waiting?
Wait, and patient
for a soft wind that would pat my face, tickle my thighs, play my toes. But the heat is heavy and the air is thin.
There is not much compassion if everybody's waiting for it.
In a heavy heart, that as if falling down. Inside, I hear something's breaking. This is the beginning.
Bad wind is messing my hair, freezing my ankles, paralyzing.
כשהבוקר הגיע והיא תזרח, אני כבר לא יודע למה חיכיתי כל יום.
Brothers, now I don't want you to be in any doubt about those who are soon to rise against you. You could attack them, right and clear. But why would you give up the true urge of winning? Get closer to your enemy. See them at their best. Demanding the right answers you get to their core. Don't expect them to narrow the access for the lack of your knowledge. Just learn more. You attack, unaware of the beauty hidden in complexities and gaps, the beauty in human hatred. I am bored by aimless shapes, bored by blind attacks. Let's see you meet your enemy for an afternoon game of chess. Let him flirt with your queen. What the hell? Let him almost rape her.
But then, catch his horses, pull the legs, and leave them screaming and losing their blood. Unable your enemy. Aim your weapon right, look straight, and don't be afraid to shoot. Stimulate him. Brothers, I got the message from the men from the house that by all means use it to encourage one another.